So hi guys, this is Varsha and you're Jing, Mastermind. So guys, as you've already seen in the title of this video, in this session we are going to discuss how to calculate the best of 5% in your ICSE board examinations, that is for your class 10. So friends, I think this is the best time to discuss how to calculate the best of 5%, that is your best of 5 rule for your ICSE class 10 board examination, since there is a pause in your board examinations due to this lockdown. You must be aware that when your results, that is your ICSE board examination results, they are published. When they are published, then you will have to calculate your percentage on your own. It is not at all given to you. You will have to calculate it by yourself. So how do you calculate the percentage, we are going to discuss. So do watch this video to the end. And if you find this video helpful, then do not forget to like and do share this video with your friends. So let us begin. So guys, you must be aware that you have overall 10 different subjects. Now how do you take out the best of 5%? So telling you that first of all, you will have to take Hindi. That is your second language. It can be Hindi or it can be any other languages. So guys, that is an individual subject. And if you talk about your computer applications or commercial applications or home science or economic applications or physical education, so this is again an individual subject. After that, if you talk about your mathematics, so that is an individual subject again. But if you talk about your science marks, so science, physics, chemistry and biology, all the three marks will be provided to you separately, but you will have to take out the average of that. In your results, it is going to be published separately, but you will have to take out the best of 5, since there is best of 5 rule. If you take physics, chemistry and biology combined, then it is going to give you one subject. There are three different subjects, but it is going to give you one subject. And if you talk about your English language and English literature, English 1 and English 2, both is combined and given, so this is one different subject. And if you talk about your HCG paper, that is history civics paper, so history civics as well as geography, this is again combined and given, so this is one different subject. So overall there are 6 subjects, since there was 10 subjects. But when you take science as an individual, as a combined subject of all the three marks, that is physics, chemistry and biology, so it is one particular subject. If you talk about your HCG paper, that is history civics as well as geography, so you will have to combine the marks, so it is going to give you one different subject. After that, Hindi is a separate subject, mathematics is a separate subject. But if you talk about your English, so English language and literature both are combined, so that is going to give you one particular subject. So overall there will be 6 subjects if you calculate, and out of that 6 subject, there is the rule that English is compulsory. That means you cannot exclude your English marks, you will have to calculate English marks, and after that you will have to take the best of 4 subjects. Overall best of 5 subject, there is a rule for best of 5 marks, you will have to take the best of 5 marks. So out of that best of 5 marks, English is compulsory, and rest 4 subjects marks, you will have to take the best of 4 subjects. So whatever subjects you have scored high, you will have to calculate that, and in whichever subject you have not done that well, you can exclude one subject. So overall it is going to give you 5 subjects, that is English plus best of 4 marks. So this is how you will have to calculate. And now how do you take out the average? So first of all, talking about how to calculate the average, so for subjects like history, civics and geography, there are 2 subjects. Whatever marks you have scored in your history, civics, and whatever marks you have scored in your geography, both marks you will have to sum up and you will have to divide it by 2, then you are going to get the average. And if you talk about your science, so since there are 3 subjects combined, so again you will have to calculate, you will have to add all the 3 subjects, divided by 3, so that is going to give you the average of your science marks. But the marks that will be published to you in the result, in that you will see that the marks are given separately. Now one question which is very common and most of you ask us in the comment section is that regarding your science marks. So physics, chemistry and biology, all the 3 marks is going to be combined. You will have to combine it and you will have to take out the average of that. So for instance, if you are passing biology and if you are passing chemistry, but if in your physics you have not done well, that well, and if you score below 33, because 33 is the pass marks, you must be knowing. So if you have scored below 33, so now if you are fail in physics, suppose, and you are passed in chemistry and you are passed in biology, but you are fail in physics, that means your percentage is below 33, you have scored below 33 marks, so are you passed? Talking about your science marks, since the science marks, it is going to be combined and given to you for both physics, chemistry and biology, for all the 3 subjects. So if your overall marks for the science subjects, if you calculate, then if it is above 33, then you are easily, you are passed. So friends, this was the video. That's all for today. And besides this, if you have still any doubts or queries related to your board examinations regarding how to calculate the percentage, so you can write to us in the comment section and I'll surely try to help you out. So friends, this was the video. Thanks for watching this video. And if you like this video, then please do give the thumbs up button and subscribe our channel, Mastermind. Thank you.